In this video, you will learn how to set up a 3D scene in 3D Studio Max with Mentalray for photorealistic visualization. We start with a completely new scene. I just go into new and just say new all. And this video is based on the setting default with enhanced menu, so it looks probably quite slightly different to what you use when you work in 3D Studio Max. The first thing we want to check are our units. That's really important because if you work photorealistic, then you have to work in the right dimensions. So the first thing I set in my display units, I go into display unit centimeters. And the most important thing are my system units. Here I also go into centimeters because that's a really good unit setting for interior spaces. If you produce your visualizations with Mentalray, it can get quite complex, but you can shortcut everything if you use render presets, and I just prepared many render presets which work quite well for architecture and interior spaces. And the first thing you do is you just load my standard render presets. You go into render setup, you go into presets, and then you just open load. You go into load, and hopefully you already downloaded the render presets from Digitalis Entwerfen, this internet page, and I just use my render preset Digitalis Entwerfen 1 standard daylight Mentalray. I just open this, and here you have different options. If you just start from scratch, I would select all options. If you already worked a little bit with your visualization, you already have a size you want to work with, and you already probably choose an exposure control which you don't like, then you just deselect some properties with your string key. Otherwise, I just choose all of them. And here we see that it just changed something. It just changed the output size, and it did many other changes of all these settings. And this is already now a good starting point to have a really good and nice photorealistic visualization. And just draw a really simple geometry for an interior space because it's just one example of how to set up a scene. Just go into box and now into my keyboard entry, and I just say I want to have a space of 6 by 10 meters and probably a height of 3 meters. I just go into create. And here we go. This is our box. This is our space. I just changed to P perspective, and here we can actually see this. And just because I also want to have a visualization from the inside, I just give this a shell function, so it's more like a volume with dimensions and with a wall. And I just give it an outer amount of 30 centimeters. And I always use straightened corners, so I really have 30 centimeters around the whole volume. This is our space, and obviously we would like to work with a daylight system. So I just go into my box again and just add one edit poly on top. Put it under my shell function and just go into a polygon and take this polygon, and I just delete this polygon. And now if you have a look at this, we just have one space with an opening for our room where the light can go in. I also want to have one window inside, and so I just go into my left view, switch off my grid, and I just draw one plane. For this I just use my snap toggle. I just press the S key, so I just have my render settings snap toggle, and I choose vertex, and I just draw one plane on in my volume. Okay, this already does it for the beginning. I just go inside and just rename this like a window, and my main object I just call it room. And, okay, the next thing is you have to give these objects materials, and I just go into my material editor, and I just use my compact material editor. I choose my first material. I go into get material, And here I just choose a really simple Autodesk material, Mentorware material. I just go into Warpaint. And what I always do is I do very few changes. I always use ambient occlusion with a max distance of 120 centimeters. And I always use color from other materials, which already looks quite nice. And then I just give this material to my wall, and I choose the next material. I go again into a get material, and I want to give my glass surface a material. I just go into Autodesk glazing. I never use solid glass. I always use glazing for windows. I just double click on this, and I leave all these settings here. Everything is fine. And I just choose my window and go again next step and say assign material to selection. With these two materials, I can already visualize my my room. Next step, I need a camera in my room to look at my inside properly. And I just go into my top view, and I just go next step into create camera. I always use target cameras because I think they're quite good to deal with. And before I enter a camera, just see one thing, that my window is still in the middle of the room. I just move it a little bit to the front, and I just go again into target, and I just create a camera like this. And in my front view, I just choose my camera with my H key, and this is my camera. I choose my camera and my target point. Okay, and I want to move my camera and my target point to eye level. So what I do is I just go on right mouse click, select and move, and just move it into the Y direction, 160 centimeters up. And this is actually a good eye level, and I normally always use my right lower viewport for my camera, and I only have one camera in my scene, so I just press C like camera, and here we go. We can already look through our camera. I can move my camera, and we have a good impression. I switch on my snap toggle, so I'm not in the wall. Actually, this is really bad. If you're too close to the wall, then actually your visualization doesn't work anymore. And we already have a good impression. And what I also do for interior spaces, I choose my camera again, and I go into a focal length of 20 millimeters or 24 millimeters, so it feels a little bit more like a proper inside view of my space. What is missing is our daylight system. So we need a light in our scene. I use a daylight actually. And here again, we go into create, and under systems, we find our daylight system. Important that you use daylight or not sunlight. Daylight includes the sun, and it also includes the environment and the sky. So just use daylight system. And if you start from scratch, you can leave this and say yes, you want to change the exposure value. Actually, at the end of the day, you will adjust it by yourself anyhow. You draw a compass at any position where it doesn't bother you with in your scene, and the size doesn't matter either. You just next draw your daylight head, and what I do is I just make very few changes. I just go into my get location, and in this time we just go to Europe and Frankfurt. We talk about this in another video. So I just set up very few things. I probably go into the afternoon, like 6 o'clock in the afternoon. And with this, we already have our basic settings for our scene. You can't see it right now, this light. So what I do, I just change into realistic. It already looks better. And in realistic, onto lighting and shadow, I just see that I don't have illuminate with default light, but illuminate with scene light. And now we're already quite close, and we have already a good impression of our scene. In theory, we can already make our first visualization, but it's quite unlikely that this will look good. because normally you always have to change your exposure control, which we do right now. It's like a normal camera, like all cameras. You go into lighting, into environment, and now exposure control. And with this little window preview, you have a first impression of your scene. And I want to increase my exposure, make it slightly more light, and probably also you can change the white point of the scene. See it like this. And if you're happy with the result, you can just visualize this and render this again. Okay, this already looks really good. A really simple scene, not much happening, and this is the result. Before we finish this video, I want to show you very few things. This visualization took 4 seconds. And if I move my head and I just move this, and you can just say turn it around, so my light comes from the back, we just see how long my visualization then actually takes. And after some minutes I cancel it, and I have a really fast computer, so instead of 4 seconds, nothing comes out of this again. And this is one of the really big mistakes. You just have to be aware of that direct light comes into your space, and it's a little bit like real life. If you just have a torch and just hold it to the moon, it first has to reflect to the moon until the light comes back. And if I just change one thing, for example, I just put one box here in front of my space and do it like this, and probably also give this again a proper material, like the same material like I gave to my room, and I go again into my rendering and I do again a visualization, we just see that it's much faster, and it just needed a surface to reflect, and in terms, instead of it doesn't do it anymore, and between 4 seconds, now it's 7 seconds. So just be aware of that always light comes into your scene, that there's something reflecting, or best case, that there's some daylight system coming directly into your scene, otherwise you will cause trouble. Okay, I undo some of the steps, and here we go. And if you look at my visualization again, here we go. You can see these horizon, and this is something I don't like so much. What you can do is you can first move this horizon, and you can also blur it a little bit. If I just go into blur 1, and actually you can also change the height, but normally I just use blur, then it already looks much better, then it's not such a clear and straight line anymore. You can even do it higher like this, and I also think it could be a little bit brighter, the whole thing, and it's probably a little bit yellowish, so I just change my white points, and just see what comes out of this, probably to 5000, and let's see what the next visualization looks like. But this is already much better. Okay, and the last thing, just quickly, if I want to give my room different materials, I just choose my room, I just put an edit poly on top, and here I go into my material editor, I just take a new material, and in this case I use the standard material, multi sub object, because my room should have several materials. I just say it should have 2 materials. I just want to give it 2 materials, and I just drag and drop it onto my room. Here we go. And right now my room looks completely dark, because there is no material in my sub material actually. So what I'd have to do is I have to choose 2 materials. The first material is this default white a wall paint, and I just copy it to another material and just call it default dark actually, and I give it a darker color, something like this, probably a little bit of a color. Okay, So, and what we do is I go into my sub-object again and go into the first material. It has the ID number 1, and I will change this later on in my edit poly. I go inside and just choose it from the lower point from my sample slot actually. I just double click on default wall paint as an instance, and I go up again to the highest level. I just go to my second ID material and just select in the lower point my wall paint dark with double click as an instance. Okay, here we go, and now this already looks much better, but I want to set it up slightly different. So what I do is I just go into my edit poly, I just select all my polygons, and the first thing I do in my menu, I go into polygon material IDs and just say set 1. So everything when I deselect it is the light version or the light material. Then I choose one polygon like this one, and here I just go into 2, and we just see that now my floor changed into 2. If I want to have more materials, then I just change the number, for example, to 3. And here again, I just have to choose any other material, whatever kind of material I want to use. I probably just say I copy this again. Doesn't make so much sense. I copy as a copy, and then I just can go inside and change my color here again, and just have something something more purple. And I go up again and call this purple. Okay, this is my ID number 1. Number 3, and if I choose this one and I change it to ID number 3, you just see what's happening. I just gave all my rooms, room service, different materials as much as I actually want. Okay, and this is what the visualization looks like. With dark materials, obviously, it gets also darker, so I just brighten it a little bit. Probably this is slightly too much, and I go again into my visualization render tool, and here we go. Looks really simple, but there's also not much happening, and this is exactly what was done in this space. So just some more objects inside and a window frame. Thanks for watching.